Hello everyone, welcome to Horror and Monster Collectibles, where today we are going to be taking a look at a piece that I just received from Chase Smith in his shop, Little Shop of Horrors. This is the Alien Big Chap Maquette. It is a quarter scale sculpt done by Bill Wieger, and Bill just did a killer job sculpting this Big Chap, and Chase did a stellar job bringing that sculpt to life. The paint and detail work is just absolutely top-notch, as you would expect from Chase. Let's spin around and we'll take a closer look. Before we take a closer look at this piece, I wanted to let you guys know what all Chase sends with the Maquette. For one thing, like, it was packed exceptionally well. There was layers and layers, and he had like little inspirational writing like on the different layers as you worked your way through the packaging, which I thought was really cool touch. And he even pushed shock sensors on the outside of the box. UPS did not choose to deliver it in a safe manner. It had received some type of shock. The shock sensor went off on it, and when I received it from UPS, two of the rear dorsal tubes were broken off, so I had to do that repair. Chase worked with me on it though, gave me some tips. I got hammered out, and again, just speaking to that, I know a lot of people get nervous as far as ordering custom pieces from people, just because it's easy to get ripped off and there are some bad shops out there, but Chase and Little Shop of Horrors is an excellent shop. I will vouch for them anytime I can, and anybody that's ordered from Chase will vouch for him too. He is a top-notch guy. He makes sure that you get a killer piece and that you are 100% happy with his work, as you would expect from any shop, but especially like a shop that does more elite style, top-notch work like Chase does. So as far as what comes in the box, I know I'm babbling on, but he includes some white gloves for cleaning and a microfiber towel also for cleaning. He gives you some black gloves for assembly of the statue. And then also, let's go ahead and take a look at the cert that it comes with, which is really cool and well done. And then also, he has an instruction book that it comes with. You can see the pieces that it has. This also has the upgraded base, where Chase has had a wood base made for it, and some LED lighting, which we'll be taking a look at once I get a closer look at the statue itself done. We'll take a look at the lighting, which has a really cool effect on there. While we're talking about the base, this part right here is just the standard base that it comes with. But Chase had this wood base made, which is killer piece. And there's LEDs underneath here, which light up the Big Chap, and it looks stellar. It was spinning around here in the back. You can see the input for the LED kit. And we'll turn off the lights and take a closer look at that here in a minute or two. Let's start at the base and work our way up. And again, his detail work is just top notch. You can see all the time that he spent as far as layering colors, and just the time that he spent trying to be as accurate to Giger's original work as possible. But I mean, it's just absolutely stunning. You really don't have an appreciation for this kind of thing until you see it in person. Hopefully that you know, my video is kind of showing all this work that he's put into it, and also that Bill put into the sculpt, because Bill did a fabulous job with the sculpt. We're gonna get focus here. Back of the hand. Let's take a look at these tubes. Now, see, the bottom two are the ones that broke off, and I did my best to paint match what Chase had done here. I think it came out pretty good. Like, you can't really tell that these are broken off at all. It's unfortunate that it happened, but again, Chase does his best to make sure that you are happy with his piece. Let's keep on taking a closer look. I mean, there's so much stuff to go over here. Hopefully, like, I'm getting most of it for you guys. Just because there is so much detail. Come around the front here. I mean, just look at the work that he's done here in the palm. Get a closer look at the face. He actually takes the time when he chromes the teeth, he polishes the teeth afterwards. Which a lot of people, when they paint, they just don't do that kind of care and time into work just because it's so lengthy. Let's look inside of the dome here. You can see all of the work that he's done inside the dome. And again, he has tons of reference photos from Giger's original paint for the suit. And he does his best to match exactly what Giger originally did. Now, the suit gets darkened just from repairs and stuff for shooting, and then also just lighting in the movie. It just gets darker, and then in post-production too. So if this looks a little lighter to you, it's simply because of all that. But this is how Giger originally painted the suit, which I wanted it true to that, and not like how it looks after filming in post-production. But it's just a killer piece. Let's look at it with the lights off. Okay, so I have it plugged in and lit up, and it just looks stunning. I love the glow from the LEDs shining up on Big Chap. On the back of here, there's a button selector for mode and speed and light color. So we'll just kind of click through these real quick and show you some of the different LED effects. Hopefully this is translating well enough for you guys. It just looks absolutely stunning. I love that he took the time to add the LED base for it.
The way the light hits off the sculpt and the paint is just tremendous, and it makes it that much more cooler. I probably won't display it lit up, but I appreciate the fact that it's there and I have that ability if I wanted to use it.
Okay, so that about covers it. As far as anybody that's curious about size for this piece, it's about 20 inches wide from hand to hand, and it is about 18 inches tall from the bottom of the base to the top of the tail, and it's about 16 inches deep. It's got a killer presence. The only thing I wish personally is that this was 1/3 scale, just because I like focusing on third scale stuff, but I have plenty of other quarter scale pieces, alien pieces, so this fits right in. I just like the bigger presence, but this is still a very big, very big piece, as you can see in my hand compared to it. But great piece, great shop. I can't recommend Chase enough and Little Shop of Horrors. Go check them out. I will have a link to their shop at the bottom of this video. And as always, feel free to like and subscribe and click the bell for notifications for new videos. And feel free to leave any questions or comments that you might have, and I will be happy to answer them.